Hospitals across Victoria are facing funding cuts that could result in layoffs and hiring freezes, with staff at the Alfred Hospital even told to turn off the lights after leaving the room. Emergency physician Dr. Stephen Parnas joins us now live from Melbourne to talk through these changes. Good morning to you, Doctor. What are you hearing from your peers in the healthcare community? Is this really a crisis like it seems to the rest of us?
Well, in my decades in the health system, I haven't seen cuts of the breadth and depth being talked about that are now very much on the table across all hospitals in Victoria.
How might this impact patients?
Well, it's the first thing to say is it's definitely going to affect clinical services. The themes that I'm seeing are that clinical staffing is going to be reduced. Contracts of temporary staff are not going to be replaced. Calls are being made for things like some outpatient services to be reduced. Waiting lists are going to get longer. Emergency services, we know that our capacity to do things is going to be diminished. So it's not looking good, and I can't really see any bright spots for this.
I mean, it's only a few years ago that we were all standing around applauding our healthcare heroes, that we were calling them, for everything they went through during the pandemic. Now governments right around the country are asking them to do more with less. How is this affecting the well-being of those frontline staff?
Well, even at the best of times, the demand on services is unprecedented. Every year you break records, and many people are still recovering from those few years. Mm. To be fair, governments really gave us everything that they possibly could during that time, and we couldn't expect that level of largesse to continue. But the cuts being suggested in Victoria are, I think, unacceptable because they're going to cause delays to care.
Do you think the government should rethink them?
I do. I think the number one priority of any state or territory government is the health of their community, and let's have some transparency about this rather than deny that it really exists.
Well, we all want them there at the worst moments in our life when we need them, so let's hope that there's enough people there for us when we do. Dr. Stephen Parnas, thank you for your time.
Thanks, Jane.